We are very, very excited about science in the middle school. The three of us have been talking quite a bit, and one of my primary things about science in the middle school is just to get kids excited about science. If I can get them to have that aha moment and say, ooh, this is something that's fun, ooh, this is something that I like, and learn something while they're at it, I've done my job. So that's really kind of the focus of middle school science. But under that, ooh, I want them to love science umbrella, there is content. The content has changed, and the way that we deliver that content has changed. We're trying to make all our science classes more inquiry-based, where the kids have input as to how things happen or why things happen, and they come up with the why on their own. The new program that we have for the middle school, this CSEET-SID that you see evidenced on the piece of paper, is brand new this year. I think it's going well. I predict that every year it's going to get better because it is an experiment in and of itself, and we learn from the results and we try to make it better next time. But the kids are getting so much out of the program. In sixth grade, that focus is primarily in environmental and metric measurement, and I'm learning who the kids are. Really, when they come to middle school, they really haven't had a whole bunch of science yet, because at lower school, it's divided up and they don't get it every day. So sixth grade is the first time where they get it every single day and they get inundated with science. At the end of sixth grade, we look at five different criteria to determine which kids would do better in this SID and SEET class. And so they are selected based on, or invited to join, based on these five criteria. The first four are objective, and then the last one would be teacher recommendation and their grades. So we try to keep it very, very objective. There is a huge waiting list of kids that want to get into this class. And in seventh grade, while the content remains the same, it is life science, biology based, in seventh grade, the kids go quicker and they go deeper. So the tests are different, the questions are different, the labs are different, the experiences are different, even though the content remains the same. And then we take it further. This seventh grade class, because they're going quicker through the curriculum, gets a huge unit on genetics, which is really cool for them to see how all this stuff comes together. Then in the eighth grade class, the kids actually take two science classes. They take their regular eighth grade content-based class with Mr. Sanders, which they're doing the physics, the chemistry, the weather and meteorology, and whatever the other one is, astronomy. They're doing that, but again, they're moving quicker. He gets through those four quarters of material that he does with the regular classes in three quarters. Okay, and then that last quarter, he and I kind of team teach. We're doing, it's more of the engineering and technology and experimental end. The entire fourth quarter, and we're about to start this, they're doing their final exam with me in the IPS course. They will get parameters, okay? It may be to build a balloon car. It may be to construct the tallest structure out of spaghetti that they can. It may be to design a Rube Goldberg machine, whatever it is. And that's, they're going to be given the size parameters, and then they have to design, they have to experiment, they have to make it work. And the first time they do it, it may be a complete fail. But that's not a fail in science. That's how kids learn. Okay? They make that mistake, they tweak and they fix and they build, and they learn every little tweaking that they're doing. So that's what the whole fourth quarter for that SEET class is. When they're with me the first three quarters, what we're doing is a course called Introductory Physical Science. It's very content narrow, but it is skill-based wide. They're learning how to analyze data. They're learning to look at where an anomaly in the data may lead them. Is it a true anomaly, or did somebody make a mistake somewhere along the line? Can we identify what that is? You don't get that in a regular science class because there's just not enough time to do it. But it's experiment after experiment after experiment in which they're learning characteristic properties. Their final exam is completely up to them. They're going to be given this huge mixture of gloop. They're going to be given this huge mixture of gloop. Their job is going to be to tell me every single thing that I put in the gloop and to prove it scientifically. And they're going to use everything that they've learned, the 3 quarters that we've been doing this, to do that. They're going to do all those experiments again, but on their own. And they're going to have to prove to me what every little piece of the gloop is. I can't think of science being more real. They're designing it, not me. Okay? So that's the seat class. What they lose to take the seat class, because they're taking two sciences in eighth grade, they lose a language arts and a communication arts, which are each a semester-long course. But to compensate for that, we've done 2 things. Mrs. Devine holds language arts kind of workshops during lunch, certain times during the quarter, so that they can get up on their skills. And then the second part of it, where I build in the communication arts and language arts, their lab reports are graded for grammar. Okay, so it's not only their science content, but their language arts is built into it. And they lose points, they lose grades. If their grammar is not perfect and those paragraphs are not constructed the way they need to be constructed for English purposes. The communication arts is put into fourth quarter. When they do their building the construction of the spaghetti or their Rube Goldberg, they have to present to the class. And they have to present about what went right, what went wrong, how many times did they have to tweak it, what worked, what didn't. All of those oral presentations will be graded then using that communication arts rubric. So they're still getting their language arts, they're still getting their communication arts, but it's in a science context. And it's something we're really, really excited about.